Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the shear stress variation diagrams and few standard cases of that. In the previous class, we have derived this particular equation, that is shear stress formula, and it is like that tau is equal to SA y bar upon BI or VA y bar upon BI, where V, S or F is the shear force at a point and A is the area above or below the particular point. Y bar is the distance from CG of the cross section, I is the moment of inertia of cross section, B is the width of cross section. As there is no area above or below the extreme fiber. Extreme fiber means what? Outer edge. If there is any cross section above that, whenever there is no area about any cross section, tau will be equal to 0, because in the equation there is a term. If A is 0, definitely tau will be 0. Now see the different shear stress distribution diagram. Initially, at the start of unit number 3, we have seen the bending stress distribution diagram. Bending stress distribution diagrams are normally a triangular in shape, means they are very linearly. Bending stresses vary linearly. But if you observe the shear stress distribution diagram, these are the shear stress distribution diagrams. But these diagrams are different for different cross sections. Okay? If width of the cross section is more, or normally at the top and bottom, shear stress is always 0. If you see the first section, a rectangular cross section, this is a rectangular cross section. For this rectangular cross section, having dimension B and D, this is shear stress diagram. This is called as a parabolic variation. This is the parabolic variation, where this tau is denoted shear stress. Shear stress is denoted by letter tau. Means henceforth, wherever there is a tau, you can say that it is a shear stress. So shear stress in the rectangular cross section is maximum at the center. Center means what? At D by 2. That is also called as neutral axis. At neutral axis, shear stress is maximum. Means at this point, tau is maximum. Shear stress is maximum. Okay, so this is the shear stress distribution diagram, that is parabolic in nature. So this is very important from exam point of view. Now see second hollow circular section. There is a hollow circular section. In hollow circular section, tau will be 0 at top and bottom. But if you see that there is a two different width. Here width is different. This is the shear stress distribution diagram for hollow circular section. If it is a solid circular section or a triangular section, in that case, shear stress diagram is also a parabolic one. It is also a parabolic one. Tau will be 0 at top and bottom, and tau will be maximum at neutral axis. Okay. So, for rectangle, triangle, circle, tau will be parabolic in shape, or shear stress diagram is parabolic in shape. But for hollow circle, we can see there will be two different points where tau will be changing. Now see next cross section. If it is a hollow rectangle, if it is a channel or C section, if it is a I section, in that case shear stress distribution diagram will be like this. Now see how this diagram is plotted. Here you can see tau at top and bottom is zero. Means always initially you draw this straight line where tau at top and bottom will be zero. At top and bottom means what? At this extreme fiber, because above, suppose I want to calculate tau here at this location in all the three sections, what happen? We need B and area. If I want to calculate tau here, I need to know area above this, and as there is no area above this, so tau will be zero. Now to find out tau at top and bottom is zero, now what will be tau at this portion or at this junction? Okay, so that value will be tau 2 here. This will be tau 2. Here this will be tau 2 at this location. This will be tau 2. See carefully. Here I have missed to show this particular value. But there should be tau 2 here. And it must be tau 3 here. And then there will be tau maximum. Means in this particular slide, here you must show tau. This is tau 1, 0 at top and bottom. This is tau 2 value at the both the locations, and this will be tau 3. Instead of tau 2, it will be tau 3, and tau 2 will be this corner, and tau will be maximum at center. Now why there are two values here? Why there are two values here, tau 2 and tau 3? Because if you see the cross section, at this cross section there are two widths. In the equation we are having formula SA y bar upon BI. If I want to calculate shear stress above this, width will be width of flange. And if I want to calculate shear stress at this wave width, it may be 10 mm and it may be 100 mm. Means there are two widths at the junction. One width may be 100 mm, another width may be 10 mm. That's why when width is more, there will be more area to resist shear stress. That's why you will obtain less value of shear stress, and that lesser value will be here, that is tau 2. And if you take B is equal to 10 mm, means there is a very small portion available or area available to resist the shear stress. If B is less, tau will be more. That's why you will obtain this second value as a tau 3. This will be tau 2, this will be tau 3. Okay, and at the neutral axis, width is 10 mm, but area will be different, because in equation formula is SA y bar upon BI. So in first case area will be area above this junction, then you will get shear stress at this location. If I want to calculate shear stress at neutral axis, then I have to consider area above neutral axis. That's why this total area will be this wave area plus flange area. But if you consider tau at these two junctions, here area will be area of flange. This wave area will not be added. Similarly, it will be for C section, it will be for rectangular section. At rectangular section also you can see first width is this total width at the top, and second width will be this 10 mm plus this 10 mm. There are two widths. In channel also this width may be 100 mm and this small width may be 10 mm. Okay. At every junction there are two values of shear stresses because of two different widths. That's why this diagram is obtained like this. And as you know that at neutral axis tau is always maximum, so this must be curve, parabolic curve, and it will show the maximum ordinate at the center. So this is the shear stress distribution diagram for I section, C section or rectangular, hollow rectangular section. In examination always there is a question for 4 to 5 marks that draw the shear stress distribution diagram for different cross sections. So in the cross section they may ask you about the channel or I section or hollow rectangle. In that case you must draw this particular figure for shear stress distribution diagram. And similarly, if they ask for rectangle, hollow circular, solid circular, triangle, then you must draw a diagram like this. Now see different sections. Now here intentionally I have taken this inverted L section, T section and L section in this way and L section in this way. Now what will be the difference? These are the unsymmetrical sections. Why unsymmetrical? Because they are not equally balanced by the area. Here there is a flange, but bottom side there is no flange. Here there is a flange, here there is no flange. Means what happened? These particular sections are called as unsymmetrical cross sections. Whenever cross sections are unsymmetrical, you know that neutral axis is not lies at center. Neutral axis is lies somewhat nearer to the bigger area. Now centroid of this particular figures will shift it towards the flanges because majority of area is concentrated in this particular region. So this red color is the neutral axis, and you two widths at the junction or at the joint, here width bigger, width smaller width, and that's why there must be two values of tau, that is tau 2, tau 3, and at this red color is the neutral axis where tau is maximum. Okay, tau is maximum. So in this way you can draw the shear stress diagram for different shapes. Okay, now see, this is the shape which is looks like a plus sign. In actual practice, there are different type of cross sections. Now here I have shown the plus sign. For plus sign, shear stress distribution diagram will be like this. So top and bottom is zero. Here, top and bottom is zero. Here there is a two widths. There are two widths here. One width is suppose 10 mm. Another width is this 100 mm or 200 mm. That's why here we will find that. So this is, these two figures are the exceptional figures. Here normally what we are saying, that tau is maximum at the center, but here it not true in this particular two cases. Because why this is so? Because in previous figures you will find that there is a very small width available at the neutral axis. It may be 10 mm, 20 mm, very small width available. But if you see this cross section, in both the cross section, here there is a larger width available at the middle portion. As the width is large, means there will be more area is available to reduce the shear stress, so tau will be less. Okay, so that's why due to the larger width at the center, here these tau values are less at the middle one. Okay, similarly in H section, you can see this is the H section. But Here larger width is available at the neutral axis to resist the shear stress. That's why this tau value is less in the at the neutral axis, and tau is maximum at this particular portion. Why it is maximum here? So here very small width available at this location to resist shear stress, means at the junction. Once you leave this width, remaining width will be 10 mm, 10 mm, 20 mm. Whenever you are considering entire width of 200 mm, then you will get the less values of tau max. Okay, so this is the difference between previous sketch and this sketch. So in this sketches, tau is not maximum at the neutral axis because of larger width available at the neutral axis to reduce the shear force. Now see the next diagram. Shear stress distribution for rectangular cross section. In the starting of this lecture, I have shown the shear stress distribution diagram. It is parabolic in nature for rectangular cross section. Now here you can see I have shown a rectangular cross section, neutral axis, total depth is d, so above the neutral axis d by 2, below the neutral axis d by 2, and width is b. And now I want to calculate shear stress at a distance y from neutral axis. Okay, so I have to consider this particular shaded area or this red color area where I want to calculate the shear stress. So our equation is tau is equal to va y bar upon br, or fa y bar upon br. Now to calculate the tau average, average value means what? Average means what? If this tau is, suppose it is 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Instead of writing all these values, number of values over the surface, actually this is the actual distribution of shear stress. Okay? But instead of that, if I want to write down the average value, what I will do? I will add all the value and then divided by number of observations. If you take the tau average, so instead of parabolic, it will be rectangle like this. So this is the average shear stress. Okay, but as you know that tau is at zero at top and bottom, so this particular diagram is not valid. But approximately in actual practice, if you are not having any calculator at that time, you can find out the average value of shear stress, and that will be using just by simple thumb rule, that force upon area, shear stress, you know that shear stress is equal to force upon area. So if you take force upon area, F upon BD, B into D is the area, you will get the average shear stress. At that time, this diagram will be like this. If you want to calculate actual value, so you should use this particular particular formula, Fa y bar upon Bi. And if you calculate with that, you will get that tau max will be equal to 3 by 2 tau average. Okay. So this is the standard observation. Tau max is equal to 3 by 2 tau average, or tau max is equal to 1.5 tau average. If you calculate actual these values, you will get the same answer. Tau max is equal to 1.5 tau average. It means tau max upon tau average is 1.5. What it shows? Tau max. Tau max means what? Tau is the shear stress. Shear stress is more by 50% than average value. Okay. Average value is suppose 10, so tau max will be 15, because it is 15% more than tau average. So everybody should know this relation. Tau max is equal to 1.5 into tau average for a rectangular section, because these are the values normally asked in competitive examination or GATE examination. They are giving this rectangular cross section and they are asking you find out the average value of shear stress or maximum value of shear stress. In that cases, you have to use this particular thumb rules. Similar to rectangular section, now you can see the triangular section. If section is triangular, I have shown width, I have shown height, its neutral axis, you know that triangle CG is 1/3 of h from bottom and 2/3 of h from top. Okay. similar to the previous case, like a rectangular case, if I want to calculate tau average, I will take force upon area, F upon area. Area means half into B into H, area of triangle. Then you will get the twice F upon BH. These two will be inverted, twice F upon BH. And tau F, this is tau average value you will get by with this equation. If you want to calculate tau max, we are having equation 3F upon BH. This will be obtained by putting the value in the equation. Okay. So, tau max is nothing but the tau at neutral axis. That will be equal to 8F upon 3BH. 8F upon thrice BH. 8F upon thrice BH. If you take the ratio of tau max and tau average, you will get the relation tau max is equal to 2.667 tau average. This is for triangle, or we can say 8/3. 8/3 tau max is equal to 8/3 times tau average, or 8/3 times means what? 2.667 times tau average. In rectangle, that value was tau max is equal to 1.5 tau average. In triangle, it is tau max is equal to 2.667 tau average, and in circular section, it is 1.33 tau average. Okay, in the similar way, you have to use this formula, find out tau max. Tau max in that case will be 4f upon 3 pi r square. As you know that tau average equal to force upon area. Force upon area means what? Area of this circle pi r square. So here you will get the relation. Tau max is equal to 4/3 tau average in case of circular section. 4/3 means what? It is 1.33 tau average. So these are the three standard cases. Rectangle 1.5, for a triangle it is 2.667, and for solid circular section it is 4/3, that is 1.33 of tau average. Okay. So these are the three values for tau max and tau average relation. It is very, very important for examination point of view. Now, here I have solved one problem for better understanding. A beam of rectangular cross section of size 80 mm and 100 mm deep. Means this width is 80 mm and depth is 100 mm. The shear force induced at the ends are 50 kN. Shear force means what? F, V or S. It is 50 kN. In Newton, it will be 50 into 10 to power 3 Newton, because 1 kilonewton is equal to 1000 Newton, or 10 to power 3 Newton. Find the shear stress in the section at. Kaha pe nikalna hai shear force? At neutral axis, means at the center. Second, 40 mm above neutral axis, means 40 mm above NA, and 30 mm below NA, 30 mm below neutral axis. Now, first of all, see the given things. Shear force is given 50 kN. Rectangular cross section is given of size ET by 100 mm. So depth is 100, width is 80. Now what will be the area of section? Area will be 100 into 80. 100 by 80. Y bar means what? This is the center. This will be the center. Neutral axis. From neutral axis, if I want to take the center of this particular area above NA, total depth is 100, means from neutral axis to this top portion it is 50. So y bar means what? Distance of this area from neutral axis, it will be 50/2, that is 25 mm. Okay, and width above the neutral axis, as it is a rectangular section, so width everywhere is same, that is 80 mm. What will be the moment of inertia of this section? You know that whenever there is a rectangular section, moment of inertia is bd cube by 12. B is ET, D is 100, BD cube by 12, you will get I. If I want to calculate NA, shear stress at neutral axis, means at this center, so I have to use this particular formula, VA Y bar upon DI. So tau max will be equal to, V means what? This shear force, A means what? Area above this neutral axis, that already we have calculated 100 into 80. Okay, this 100 into 80, that area will be 100 into 80. Sorry, sorry, there is one mistake here. It is not 100 into 80. This area must be area above NA. Above NA means what? This 80 mm is width, but from NA this width is only 50. This width is only 50, depth is 50. Instead of 100 into 80, this area must be 50 into 80. Okay, 50 into 80 means what? 4000. So here make correction, instead of 8000 to take it 4000, because I have to calculate shear stress at neutral axis. So I have to consider area above neutral axis, and that area above neutral axis is, it is not 8000, it is 4000. We make this correction, 15 to 10 to power 3 into 4000 into 25 is the y bar, distance of this area from neutral axis. B, width at this particular neutral axis is 80 mm, and moment of inertia is 6 into 66 10 to power 6. By solving this, I will get the value 18.76, but it is for 8000 area. You find out value for 4000 area and write down here. Correct this 18.76. Now, second location. In the problem, they have asked shear stress at NA, that we have calculated. Now 40 mm above NA and 30 mm below NA. Now second case is 40 mm above NA. So this is the neutral axis. 40 mm above NA means what happened? Total depth is 50. From 50, if you deduct the 40, what is remaining depth? It is 10 mm. Means this depth is 10 and this width is 80. 80 is the width and this depth is 10. Means only for 10 mm, what is the shear stress that you have to calculate using this formula. So area will be 80 into 10. This 80 is the width and 10 is the depth. Y bar means what? From neutral axis, what is the center of this particular area? So where will be the center? This 40 plus 10 by 2 means 40 by 2. The center of this area will be at 45. Same thing I have written here, and width at this location is 80 mm. So you put all these value in the equation, shear force, then area, then y bar, b is 80 mm, and moment of inertia is same, that is 6.66, 10 to power 6, we have taken that in previous case. Same I should be used for all calculations. By solving this, we will get tau at 40 mm above neutral axis. It is not maximum, this tau max, this one is wrong. It must be tau at 40 mm, that is 3.375. okay, so this is maximum value, this is 6 mm, and here it must be 3.375. at 18.76 is wrong, it is maximum value. Here instead of 18.76, this value should be 3.375 at 40 mm, at this particular point. Now third point they have asked, calculate the shear stress 30 mm below NA. Below, this is the neutral axis, below neutral axis 30 mm. Move 30 mm below, then total depth is 50, because total depth is 100. From that you have to deduct this top 50, means remaining will be 15. From that you have to calculate shear stress at 30 mm. Means if you deduct this 30 mm from 50, so remaining width will be, remaining depth will be 20. So this 20 into width is 80. Means you have to calculate tau at this particular location. So what will be the area? Area will be 80 into 20. Y bar means what? Center of this area from neutral axis. So from neutral axis, this 30 plus this 20 by 2 means 10. It will be 40 mm. And B is same, that is 80 mm. And if you put V, that is 15 10 to power 3. Area, area is 80 into 20, 1600 into Y bar 40. Divided by B into I, we will get tau at 30 mm from bottom, and that value is 6 MPa. Means at 30 mm it is 6 MPa, at center it is 18.76, at 40 mm it is 3.375. okay, so in this way, by using the flexural equation, you can find out shear stress at different locations. So here everywhere you have to use this formula, that is SA y bar upon BI, very carefully, so that you will obtain the correct values. Now in next lecture, we will see few numericals on the particular topic. Thank you very much.